All right, guys, turkeys are infamous for making lots of different sounds, right? But sometimes it can be confusing of when to make what sound when you're turkey hunting. Today on Land Beat, we're to cover all the different calls turkeys make and when you should be using them when in the field. So let's start from the very beginning. Let's say we're getting out of the truck, we're heading into the woods, we've got a spot we're gonna listen to. We hear a bird gobbling on limb and then we go get set up. What are the first calls that we're gonna use while that bird's on the limb? Well, number one, we wanna keep things as natural as possible. We don't wanna go in and start cutting and blasting at that bird on the limb. We wanna sound and be just like a turkey. So naturally, we're gonna follow that same kind of progression of turkey calls in a morning that a hen would naturally make as she's waking up on the limb. So what I mean by that are tree yelps. Tree yelps is a series of yelps, but they're soft. They're kind of that inner flock talk as you have several birds roosted close together. They're not trying to make these sounds and carry hundreds and hundreds of yards. This is close proximity talking. They're just waking up and they're starting to chat into or in between multiple different birds within close proximity. So for me, I'm gonna use this pot. It's got a more hollow, softer sound. So this is not going to carry a long ways. And I'm gonna replicate what a tree yelp would be. And this is my first call as I interact with that gobbler who's set up 150 yards plus or minus away from me. A lot of people don't even know that turkeys make that sound because they haven't either been paying quite enough attention or haven't been close enough to a lot of birds on the limb. But that soft tree yelp has the same cadence, high to low, as a yelp is gonna have, but it is almost more muffled and hollow as they're just trying, again, communicate to one another on a limb. So when you make that sound, it kind of tells that gobbler, hey, I'm in close proximity to you. I'm not trying to wake up all riled up. I'm just doing what a natural turkey does. And you do have to be, you know, within a certain distance for that gobbler to hear you making those softer tree yelps, but it keeps things natural. Next up, let's go into yelps. Yelps is kind of the next series in that you'll hear birds on the limb talking back and forth. And that is just a series of multiple yelps. Let's just pick up this friction call that a hen is commonly gonna use while on the limb before she pitches down. And then of course, while she's on the ground, yelps are obviously very commonly used. But let's go to a yelp. This is what it's gonna sound like. So it's got that same two-tone note that the tree yelp had, but it's a much higher pitch. And that's gonna carry quite a bit farther. So this is, you know, several minutes after we've made the tree yelp, we're gonna reach back out. That second contact with that gobbler, probably gonna use a series of yelps as she's still on the limb. Next up, she's made that yelp, a series of yelps, communicating. Maybe we've got some other hens that we're trying to compete with that are in the area. Maybe they've responded back. The next kind of natural progression of birds is to do a fly down cackle. This is the sound as birds are actually getting off the limb. So if you've ever been fortunate enough in an early season situation to watch birds before all the leaves are out, they will stretch their wings, stretch their necks, begin to look, lean off the limb, it seems like, picking their spot to land. And then the hen is going to do this fly down cackle as she's pitching down. So again, to make things much more realistic, this is where the wing comes in. Using this wing to make it sound like she's actually flying down. So we're not only making the audible noise that she's gonna make, but also the other noise that her wings are gonna make as she pitches off that limb. So let's replicate a fly down cackle. I should also note that it starts off slow, increases in intensity, and as she's pitching off the limb, when I bring this wing into the call itself, it's a rapid series of cackling. I'm sitting on leaves, I'm gonna use this wing to make it sound like she's then landed and hit the leaves as well. Let's do it one more time. Now that bird is down on the ground, landed, and ready for the next series. One of the most common calls that you're gonna see on highlight reels of turkeys is cutting, right? It's kind of the high intensity responding back and forth that you're gonna have with a gobbler. And it kind of is a more or less aggravated hen. She's cutting back and forth loudly to bring attention to herself and kind of show dominance into the situation. So cutting, so you can hear it on the limb, but more or less used quite a bit once that hen has already flied down. So let's replicate cutting. We can do that with a box call, we can do that with a slate. I'm gonna choose to do a diaphragm call. Threw in a couple yelps, but then broke it right up with a couple cuts in there as well. It's just a loud, firm cut on a diaphragm. Let's replicate that real quick on a box call because this kind of sounds a little bit different. I use that in situations where trying to really excite that gobbler, bring him in, maybe he's held up at 100 yards, haven't fully committed, or I have another hen who's entered the situation, I'm gonna start cutting at that to bring up the excitement level and hopefully close that bird in. As you're closing that bird in too, we have to be mindful of the volume that you have. And similar to a bird tree yelping, when you're in closer proximity to a gobbler, it's not a very loud call. The next call, purring, is one that is also used when birds are pretty close in proximity. Let's say 100 yards or less. So when birds are naturally feeding in a flock, you hear lots of purrs and little clucks as they're talking to one another. It's kind of like inner flock talk. So as we're trying to get that bird, that gobbler, to commit to the situation, again, we want to be very natural and replicate what naturally happens as birds are talking. As he's closing in, we're going to use that purr. I'm going to purr on the diaphragm, and then we'll pick up the friction call as well. Friction call, especially this one with the surface that it has, it's going to carry a little bit further, but I typically, especially as a bird is coming in, so I'm hands-free and hands on the gun, I'm going to purr on a mouth call. In relation or in conjunction with purring, I'll take the wing and I'll be scratching in the leaves as well. Most times, turkeys are not just standing still in the timber. They're often moving, they're often foraging, they're often looking around. So as you're purring, it's very common to have birds feeding as well. So maybe I will be purring on the diaphragm, but then scratching in the leaves with the wing to replicate again a real life situation. It just gives your setup that much more confidence to a longbeard to make him commit. And I'll use that right next to me if that bird's not within range or can see me to scratch in the leaves and purr as well. That's a great breakdown of a lot of different turkey calls. There's a lot of different nuances and situations that you can use all those different calls. But that's the general breakdown of how I'm going to be talking back and forth to a turkey. So it takes some time to master those different calls and understand when is best to use them. But once you have, you can really be talking turkey, making good clear sounds, but make sure you're saying the right things at the right time to the turkey, again, which builds confidence in your setup and allows you to fill more tags and be successful each spring.